fight for equality. Of course, there are so many, many different challenges or problems that we face. Like I said, that's why I said we use dialogue. We invoke respect. We think of our culture and tradition if we want to fight for injustice. Because countries like the Gambia, you cannot just wake up and say, I want to fight for injustice. I want to become the woman power. I know my rights. I want to do this. This is not the case in Gambia. The challenges you face is that you will not be respected. Traditionally, they might denounce you. Even your own parents might denounce you that you are no more part of us because you have taken a different route. This is not what we expect you to advocate for. You were supposed to be a housewife. You were supposed to be a woman of tradition and respect, but not going out and blah blah and everywhere. Sorry for my language. So these are a lot of challenges that you have. You could even feel restricted to some families or even in the society. They might frown at you. They might look at you as, who is she? Why is she fighting injustice? We are her parents. You know, the issue of FGM, I said, they achieve their objective, their goals, not 100% through dialogue, not being radical. So, I mean, there are a lot of challenges, but if we take it easy, we will reach there. Because it all here. You make someone understand why, how, then I'm there. Education for women and girls is 100% important. There's a saying goes, that there's a saying that says, if you educate a woman or a girl, you educate the whole world. This is the fact. Yeah? Because if we are educated, we are the world today. We are parents. We are women. We are mothers. Yeah? We play a different role. So having all of those perspectives at once, if you educate us, I mean, we can break the barriers. If I am educated, for example, I go to school, at least I know my rights, both in the African and European context, but in Africa, I cannot forcefully use this right because it may be like I abusing this right. So therefore, I have to engage in dialogue. In Gambia, I have a column called Women Bantuba and also on the radio talking about this. Tell people telling their success stories, the challenges that they face also. And this is something that I intend to, you know, do as well. So if you educate a woman, you educate the whole world, and the world becomes a better place with women. We all know this. That has to do with the success stories, and its impact. It has changed a lot. Because in the Gambia, I aspired a lot to migrate to Europe or America. This was my intention because I'm like, if I travel to Europe, I have better education. I have access to almost everything that I want. This is the thought that I have. Because I was 100% aspired to travel to Europe and get all of those things. I was like, okay, if I'm in Europe, I would not be so disturbed with the societal ideologies that I am a woman. I have to respect the norms, the traditions. I have to respect 100% I'm a woman. You know, I will not be afraid to have to fall in love, to choose the husband that I wanted. This is the aspirants that I have. But when I came to Europe, it's something different. Yes, you have the right to do anything that you want to. But this thing, emancipated, is still part of me. Because if I want to do anything or want to do extra, I think of my culture. I think of my tradition. I think of my parents, that it is important. If I do, it reflects back, and they know. And my inner self will not let me doing this. So this question of, you know, the aspiration to migrate and the success story. My fellows in Gambia see me in Europe. Oh, woman is doing good. Look at her, just less than 2 years, she's in Europe. She is talking, she's following her career or so. Do they know how I live? It's lonely here, you know?
Yeah.
It could be paradise, but it's hell in other path. You live alone without family. You had to, you know, live with the status quo as a migrant. Yeah? I have seen, because there is a different sectors between a migrant and a refugee. I have seen people discriminating this thing into two different things. So as a migrant, we still have the same status quo as a foreigner. And even though we have rights, but not the equal right as you, German. So you there in Gambia watching me, thinking that I'm in paradise, the migrant aspiration is quite different from what we are seeing here. So the success stories, my success stories, should not implicate you to an extent. You forcefully travel in bad ways, do something that will lead you to Europe, and then the expectations are quite different. Climate change is not so sustainable, it might be difficult, because in Africa, especially in the rural areas, yeah, these women rely 100% on land.
Yeah.
And if we're into climate change or so, if it doesn't work for them, they would not leave. Because this is the only soil to sit on. You know, this is the only source of living that they have, because they are uneducated, they're illiterate, sorry for my language. They're not self-determined, they're restricted, they're abused, there's all sorts of violence, they lack their self-esteem, they don't have the voice. Mm-hmm. At least in Gambia, the difference between the rural area and urban area, at least it's a little bit different, because we have at least a higher rate of educated than the uneducated in the rural area. So this helped a little bit. In the rural area, at 13 days, you go and get married. You should be a housewife. Your voice should not be so loud. You were supposed not to be everywhere. People see me sometimes as, you know, they often tell me this. But I look at them and I'm like, okay, is there thinking? What kind of man would you want to marry? Want to marry you because you were like, you know, they see me as the 50-50. This 50-50 has a different interpretation in the African context. They thought, yeah, what a man can do, a woman can do, this I believe in. But for them, they thought that the 50-50 belief is that if a man do this, a woman must do this. Yeah? This is not the case. For me, I tell them that the 50-50 is about helping you men. It's not about me being equal with you. Even in Muslim, from God, we were never equal. Women are from the groups of men. So therefore, we started to obey you as our husbands, as our fathers, as our elders. So we are just, the 50-50 concept is to help you. You provide five, maybe I provide one from the household. We can have a happy family. But it's not about how the way men in Africa taught that he sees challenging me. So I had to show that I'm the man, just do whatever I want. So it is really something that is really difficult. That's the problem. And I think we really have to talk about this. We really need to engage, have dialogues, you know, have projects.
Yeah.
If the Western world want migration to stop, which they are currently, you know, talking about, they're trying to look an issue for this, which, you know, I'm really looking forward to the criminalization of this migration and the Mason plan. They should like 100% to eradicate migration. Can they do that? No. I think they are doing this in a radical way. Dialogue. Give them, you know, solutions. Why they should not migrate? Tell me, why should I not migrate? And what is there for me if I stay back? But you just come and say, I give you 1.2 billion to Gambia. Everybody should stay in Gambia. Do I see or know where this 1. Something billion is going on? If I'm from the rural area, or if I am that woman that does not have the voice or the access to these things, I will go through Libya to travel to help my family. So let us not do it in a radical way. The Europeans should understand that radicality, this neocolonialism has been there, and it has affected us. It's like emancipating. We Africans are trying to emancipate, and this would really disturb us. For me, I think we cannot emancipate, because I never knew about this global neocolonialism or so. It was from my foreparents, forefathers and mothers. But if I listen to the stories, I watch the movies, it hurts me. We were forced to come to Europe, to America. We were forced to be colonized by our forefathers and mothers. Now these people are no more. In exchange of our national resources and everything, now I want to travel to Europe to at least not to get these national resources, but to help my family and my country. You are denying me by giving me such euros to stay. It's a country of almost 2 million people. Africa is about 1.2 billion people. if you give 1.2 million to a population of 1.2 billion people, how do you expect all of us to have access to all of this money while we have corrupt and greedy leaders? What happened? So let's engage them in a dialogue. Well, I know in the European standard, it's not about respect or it's not about culture or tradition, but they should also learn our cultures and traditions to understand us when they are dealing with us. Because we, when we migrated to here, we learned the cultures and traditions of Germany. We integrate, we learn the language, even though we don't like the food, but we have to because we're here. Now, this is the fact. Like you said, you don't know much about the culture of Africa, especially in Gambia, but this is the fact. Engage us, not in a radical way. Yeah? Tell us why, how. Provide me something, give me something. I will stay in Africa. I do not migrate to Germany to get access to the rights or whatsoever people thought we are here for. Many people thought Africans came to Europe for economic reasons. My recent discussion with Angela Merkel, the Chancellor of Germany, when I asked her, why is it that African migrants do not have equal access and rights like the other migrants? Her response was, because most of you, if not all African migrants, migrated to Europe due to economic reasons. And if you have this money, you send it back to your family. Okay, I did not make a further discussion. But I tell her, it's not every goal that glitters is a goal. Actually, in sense, it is. Not every African migrant migrated to Europe in such a greener pasture. People have so many different views. So it has to be balanced. Encourage us. Also learn our cultures and why we're here. We will make a better world.